Number 21, the graph of a linear function passes through the points below. Which equation represents the function? Let's take a look. Let's start by just graphing the points on our coordinate grid. This grid doesn't, it moves by force, so you can see that there's four sections in between each integer on the x and the y axis. So it's set up kind of nicely for us. So our first point is -1, -1/4. That point will be right there in quadrant 3. And let's go ahead and plot the other one. We have +1, -3/4. That will end up in quadrant 4. And we can just go ahead and take a line and connect these because it's a linear function and linear means line. So let's go ahead and connect those and see what we're working with. Now, I always talk with my students, when it goes downhill, it looks like that slope is going downhill. It's going to be a negative slope, down, negative. It makes sense. So when we take this, we're going downhill. We know our slope when we look at mx plus b, m, the value times x will be our slope. Our value has to be a negative value. So b and d are positive. So when we look at that, A and C are the only ones that have a negative slope. So we can eliminate B and D. Now we just need to figure out where does this line cross the y-axis. We'll put that point right there. Our y-intercept is right there. And when we use mx plus B, B is our y-intercept. That point is intercepting right at negative. It's going to be on the negative side, so it's not positive. So our answer choice is going to be, and it's right in the middle, it's going to be at -1/2. So which equation represents the functions? C, y equals -1/4x -1/2.